3 weeks since the vote that's thrown Britain into a state of upheaval.
Calling the referendum in favour of leave.
And the shockwaves are still reverberating.
Are you looking forward to your new role?
Politically, the changes have been sweeping, with Prime Minister Theresa May clearing out the old cabinet of David Cameron.
One of the most massive government reshuffles we've ever seen, and I think Theresa May is trying to underline a complete cut-off from the government of David Cameron and George Osborne.
One day into her job, and this Prime Minister's showing she's not afraid to shake things up. There have been high-profile casualties in the Chancellor of the Exchequer, George Osborne, and Justice Secretary Michael Gove. And then two new faces and posts, David Davis, the new Brexit minister, and Liam Fox, Secretary of International Trade, both Brexiteers.
There's a massive difference between leaving the EU and our relations with Europe.
But the most surprising appointment went to one of the architects of the Brexit campaign, Boris Johnson, who has grabbed a top job as Foreign Secretary.
Three Leave campaigners in the three departments which will cope with Britain's exit from the European Union. Then if anything goes wrong, if compromises have to be made, it gets blamed on the Brexiteers.
And while the political landscape is being shaped, the economic one is still in need of major massaging. Sterling is down more than 10% versus the US dollar. Sentiment in the UK housing market has suffered its worst drop in 18 years, and consumer confidence has fallen sharply. Yet the Bank of England has decided to hold fire on interest rates, keeping them unchanged at a record low of 0.5%, perhaps triggered by the earlier-than-expected appointment of a Prime Minister who means business.
I hope that's going to start lifting the fog for many investors, many businesses, and we will gradually see confidence rebuilding.
But many will argue we're not there yet. Questions remain over Britain's role in Europe and when it will actually leave the European Union. And then don't forget, there's a major rebellion underway in the opposition party. Proof, perhaps, that Britain's still pretty much trying to find its way in this post-Brexit reality. Isa Soares, CNN, London.